sehr erfolgreich war, der dann irgendwann den Schritt in Richtung PDC gewagt hat. Er war in diesem Jahr beim World Cup of Darts in Frankfurt für Polen mit dabei. Er hat sich jetzt zum wiederholten Male hier für die European Tour qualifiziert und man merkt ihm an, er fühlt sich immer wohler auf der großen Bühne. Aktuell die Nummer 97 der Welt, the Polish Champion, Krzysztof Ratajski. Krzysztof Ratajski nimmt es mit einem Engländer auf, 27 Jahre ist er alt, bei ihm läuft es wirklich immer besser in den letzten anderthalb Jahren. Er hat in diesem Jahr seinen ersten PDC-Titel gewinnen können. Letztes Wochenende stand er noch im Halbfinale von Wien. Inzwischen die Nummer 22 der Welt. Die Rede ist vom Rockstar Joe Cullen.
Joe Cullen, the Yorkshireman, the number 14 seed here this weekend at the Happy Bet European Darts Open, looking to make it four seeded players out of four through to the final day of action. We've already seen wins for Daryl Gurney, Gerwin Price and Alan Norris. Can the rock star join them in the last 16? Well, to do that, he's going to have to overcome the Polish champion, the man who turns up to the East European qualifier and without fail wins it. He's done it eight times this year, Krzysztof Ratajski. And he keeps knocking on the door of a spot in the final day of Euro Tour events. Maybe today is his day. And he does go through to the last 16. It is Cullen versus Ratajski. I'm Dan Dawson. Chris Murphy joins me in the commentary box for this one. And Ratajski is not a player to be underestimated, is he?
Certainly not. The pride of Poland against the pride of Yorkshire right now, Joe Cullen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg is Krzysztof to throw first. Game on.
And as you said, Dan, Ratajski looking to reach the final day of action in the European Tour event for the very first time. He's had some fantastic results.
100!
We've seen him in every single one of this year's European Tour event. Perfect record in qualifying.
57.
Joe Cullen, number 14 seed. Important match for him. The man who was a semi-finalist last weekend in Austria. Talking to Paul Nicholson earlier on, and those players in the lower seedings, it's really important to win this second round match so they add to their ranking money and keep their seeding.
Yeah, well, all three seeded players have managed to do that so far today. Jerry Hendricks and Mark Walsh put up stern examinations of Daryl Gurney and Gerwin Price, but couldn't quite get over the line. Aidan Kirk taken apart by Alan Norris in the early stages, but Ratajski looking to take Joe Cullen apart, fires in his first maximum.
Yeah, gets him down to 1-2-1, and he's going to have a couple of minutes to mop it up. Might not need them. What a start from Krzysztof Ratajski, just wide of the mark. But that won't bother him. This could bother him.
Bother him a lot. Maximum for Joe Cullen to leave double 12, but will he get a go at it? No, he will not. 13 darter from Krzysztof Ratajski.
Same thing as Joe to throw first. Game on.
Well, played at a good pace this match. Cullen hit a 180 last visit. Can he make it back to back?
140.
Not quite.
$137.
Good response from Ratajski. Looks at it, doesn't he, today?
Certainly does. He's going to give Joe a good run for his money.
$57.
An unflappable character, Krzysztof Ratajski.
97.
I mean, it's looking through some of his results when he's played in WDF events, Dan, and he's beaten the likes of Martin Adams.
121.
Still one of the top players in world darts.
Yeah. Hey, look, Rutoyski's been putting in very, very good performances and seems to be getting better and better. Now, he averaged nearly 96 yesterday in a 6-1, well, battering of Mark Berilli, really. Very impressive, but not a surprise from Krzysztof Rutoyski. We're going to be seeing him at the European Championship in Hassel. He's, you know, he could be one of the top seeds if he keeps qualifying for these and keeps picking up a few grand each weekend.
Well, he's
137.
It will certainly be interesting to follow his progress over the next year or two. He's got perhaps Menzo Suljovic as a marker 56. To follow.
Krzysztof Uruguay, 71.
71 to double his lead. 18 for tops. One dart at it for 2-0. Great start from Rutoyski.
Third leg is Krzysztof to throw first.
Yeah, he was one of the top performers in round one. Looking to follow it up here against Joe Cullen. The top performer is James Richardson. He'll be in action next against Benito van der Pas.
101.
We've also got Kim Huybrechts against John Henderson, another Belgian, Dimitri Vandenberg up against Australia's Simon Whitlock, and Stephen Bunting closing this afternoon session against Germany's Stefan Zietmann, a man who has made the final day of the European Tour events. Rutoyski hasn't, but he's not a long
85.
Way off. There's four legs, in fact.
Yeah, it was Joe Cullen who was beaten by Stefan Zietmann to make the final day of the Euro Tour earlier on this year.
It 99.
Was Joe Cullen who was, well, without going into too much detail, very poorly. And Zietmann took advantage. It is a healthy and informed Joe Cullen that Rutoyski is taking on here, but he's still been too good for him in the opening couple of legs.
Yeah, I know he was disappointed with his semi-final performance last weekend, Joe Cullen, because up until that match he had been fantastic in Vienna. His best run since winning Players' Championship 8, his first PDC senior title, Joe Cullen, who tested victory on the development tour going back 6 years now.
47.
Still only 27, Joe Cullen, a man who seems to have been around for a very long time. A baby in darting terms.
98.
Yeah, it's exciting and seeing the strides that Joe Cullen and Darryl Gurney have made, and Gerwyn Price, you'd probably lump in, over the last year and a half.
92.
Those three have made big improvements to their games, and they're all young guys who've got years ahead of them. As Cullen needed another treble 19 for a dart to the bullseye, and Rutoyski has a chance to make it 3-0, but there's huge pressure on this.
Yeah, he may well have needed another treble 19, because Krzysztof Rutoyski, well, didn't need it in the end. And this will be for a break. And just to
82.
Stop Rutoyski running away with it.
Well, it doesn't really matter that Rutoyski has gone for the treble 19 and let himself go for 17, because Cullen takes out the 28 and gets a break straight back, and an important break straight back as well.
Yeah, we commented on the Darryl Gurney match earlier on. He was fabulous. 8-1-8s in that win. 6-5 in the end against Jerry Hendricks, but certainly Gurney and Cullen's sort of progression at the same time. They won the first titles on the same weekend. Gerwyn Price, a slightly different case, because he only turned professional in 2014.
Yeah.
The other two have been around a long time. And but talk about those three as the upcoming stars.
140.
Doors opening. So far, Gurney and Price have been afforded spots on the World Series tour. I'm sure those kind of doors will open for Joe Cullen before so long.
Yeah, if he carries on playing like he is, and if he can add to that title haul. I mean, you know, the three players you just mentioned there is Rutoyski.
139.
139. Good. Gets him down to a finish. Cullen, the 167. It's a massive one, bullseye.
142.
Well, not far away. Rutoyski just needs one treble to get a shot to that target, but he could still do it. Treble 20 for ball. Not going to be. 50. So Joe Cullen to level up
25.
At 2-2, wants 25. Double 8. can't get any closer Games without hitting it, and he does hit it.
Bidlegger's Christoph to throw first. Game on.
Now we have a good game on here. Christoph Ratajski and Joe Cullen battling it out for a spot in the last 16 to face either Mensur Suljević or Christian Kist.
98.
Joe being watched by his
58.
Best mate in darts, Devin Peterson. Returning the favour after Cullen was cheering him on last night, although it was an absolutely horrific show of doubling in the final match of the night last night. Devin Peterson somehow coming through that game.
Yeah, I'm sure he'd be the first to agree that it was the worst win of yesterday's session.
140.
2-2, 3-3 apiece in this leg. Although Ratajski's going to take a chunk out of his score. Most players would have started on treble 19
137.
Well, yeah, and now he's left himself with a bogey number. Strange, that.
Yeah, Cullen does start on treble 19.
139.
Could be the difference between winning and losing this game. If Cullen takes out the 164 and gets a break. And there you see the importance of counting.
Yeah, well, he had a shot of the ball line from 167, so it's not beyond the realms of possibility. Certainly not now. Another one of those.
96.
Well, Ratajski may only get a dart at the bullseye himself here. 11s. It is the ball. Oh, he's a long way off there, Christoph Ratajski. Cullen, to make it three legs on the spin and go into the lead. And you're going to get one dart. Double 16's the target.
30.
Just outside.
Christoph Iroquois, 33.
Well, the miss has left him a two-darter, and it's two darts. One at double 16, the next at double 8, but it's found double 11.
Joe Iroquois, 32.
Double 8.
24.
Oh, Joe Cullen.
Christoph Iroquois, 33.
Four darts miss now for a breaker throw-in to go into the lead for the first time. Ratajski, it's the same equation as last time, and it's the same thing happening.
17.
Well, the ultimate result is that he doesn't win the leg in that visit. So he may as well have bust it. Because Cullen looks at double 4,
game
and there
the
it is.
Leg. Joe Cullen. Second leg is Joe to throw first. Game on. $134.
Christoph Ratajski was 2-0 up and absolutely flying at the start of this game.
$139.
But a series of missed doubles have let Joe Cullen nip into the lead. And is Ratajski going to suffer 80. Second round disappointment once again on the European Tour?
Bit of lucky there, that for Joe Cullen, seemed to bounce off the point of the other dart, could have been a 140, ended up just being 80.
100!
Ratajski gets his nose in front, but not by an awful lot, Cullen still in control.
108!
Very impressive stuff this from Joe Cullen, that is his second 180, having been 2-0 down. It's his temperament, and it's something that's been noticeable over
60.
His improvement over the last few months, that he doesn't panic.
Yeah, unflustered, cool, calm and collected character.
Nice
Joe Cullen.
And you'll see he'll let out big releases. You know, it does mean a lot to him. It's not like he doesn't care. When he takes out a big shot, you'll see him screaming literally on stage sometimes.
But he doesn't seem to
require
the hockey under any kind of duress.
Exactly.
Double two.
Game shot on the
double
sixth.
Two.
Joe Cullen. Seven legs, Christoph to throw first. Game on.
To Joe Cullen. Having trailed 2-0.
139.
Well, Ratajski went out in the first round last weekend in Austria, beaten by Kim Villian and the Finn, and he missed a series of match darts in that game, Ratajski. I saw him afterwards. I didn't have a word with him because he was absolutely crestfallen. He was basically sat in the corridor. And he was understandably distraught
85
at having failed to get through that game. But I think Viljanen put into perspective that game by going on and running to the quarterfinals. Played very well, beat Peter Wright in the next round. So Ratajski has suffered disappointments. I mean, he's been very, very 85. Close to winning one of these second round games. But he's just coming up short here against Joe Cullen. Snarl.
140.
Yeah, well, he's certainly in contention still, Ratajski. Not far behind in the statistics. Well, he's running this leg, but it's not a guarantee that he will get a shot.
Bullseye for Cullen. 5-2, bang in the middle of the board. And Joe Cullen, 12 darter, has put him in complete control of this game. 5 legs on the spin for Joe Cullen.
And he made it look so easy. He does make it look so easy when he's on song, Joe Cullen. Checking that one out quicker than a cashier at Lidl.
26 to follow it up, and he salutes the crowd sarcastically.
140.
Joe Cullen averaging around about 98. Christoph Ratajski once again averaging, well, there you look, there you go. 96 average from Christoph Ratajski, 108 first nine. It's been good, but Cullen has just taken out the right shot at the right time.
Yep.
And that 127, a prime example.
70.
Been reading the MVG textbook, hasn't he? Doing the right thing at the right time and not making many mistakes.
Can't afford any mistakes.
123.
MVG will be in action this evening against VVDV. Vincent van der Voort taking on his good friend. Unless he's pushed him down the stairs or something at the hotel, because he did say in his interview last night, I hope he gets injured. And I did see him sort of following Michael around.
140.
With a menacing look on his face.
Well, Cullen has left himself 78 for the match. The last 5.5 legs from Joe Cullen have been excellent. And Christoph Ratajski, another solid display for the Polish champion. But it looks like it could be another second round exit for Ratajski. And that's exactly what it is. Joe Cullen once again has put in a very assured, confident display. And it is the Yorkshireman who is through to the third round. We will see him take on either Christian Kist or Mensur Sulevic, those two facing off in a fantastic-looking evening session. But we've got 4 more games for you this afternoon, and it continues with Benito van der Pas against the top performer from round one of the Happy Bet European Darts Open, ruthless James Richardson.
Letzten drei Veranstaltungen, Viertelfinale, Viertelfinale, Halbfinale. So congratulations, 6 legs in a row. It's just a question of self-confidence if the opponent is 2-0 up and you still seem relaxed and know that what you can do.
Yeah, definitely. Christoph's qualified for every Euro event so far, and obviously I've seen a few of his games in the past. I could have played the other week, and he's really playing really well, so I knew I had to turn up today. But yeah, when he was 2-0 up, I just thought, just carry on as you are. I've not done much wrong, so yeah, just obviously I didn't expect to get the next 6, but yeah, I'm just happy to get the win.
Yeah. After 2 quarterfinals on a European tour, the semi-final last week, the next step, final, the win?
Yeah, that's. I thought I was going to win last week, if I'm honest. I just went out of steam a little bit in the semis, and sort of Michael took advantage of that, but why not? I'm good enough to win one of these easily, so why not?
And you get closer to the top 16. That really looks good. 22 right now in the rankings. That's the next goal aim, I'm sure.
It's not so much the next goal. It's the top 16 will come with TV performances. I'm not saying I'm going to get to the top 16. That's my goal. It's qualify for every TV event and do well, and that'll come straight afterwards.
Thank you, Joe. Joe Cullen, der Mann hat viel Selbstvertrauen. Der sagt, warum nicht auch so ein Turnier gewinnen, wenn du in den letzten Wochen so gut gespielt hast.